Bible declares that we ought to enter his gates with thanksgiving and enter his courts with praise. So I want y'all to open up your mouths and give God the salutations and what is due him. I can't praise God for you, but you can do it for yourself if you are willing and desire to. Oh God, we just want to bless you. We want to lift you up, God, because you're worthy, God. There is none other like you. There is none other like you, God. You are the King of Kings and you are the Lord of Lords. You are great, God, and you are greatly to be praised. There's none like you, God, now, then, and even to come, Lord. You are truly one of a kind, God. And we want to bow down to you on today, God. We want to give you our best praise and our best worship. We are not going to be too cute. We're not going to worry about who he and who ain't. We're not going to worry about what they're doing and what they're not. Oh, God, but we're going to simply concentrate on you, Lord. We're not going to be distracted. We're not going to worry about anything but you right now, God. We're going to concentrate on you, God. And we're going to lift you up because you said that if we lift you up, Lord, you would draw all men unto you, God. So I'm asking you to draw your people a little bit closer. I'm asking you to draw just a little bit near, God. Because we want to lay at your feet and we want to hear your voice. We want to be in your presence, God. Oh, God, oh, God, oh, God. We want to feel your spirit on tonight, God. And we're welcoming you into the sanctuary. We're welcoming you into our hearts. We're welcoming you into our minds. We're welcoming you into our bodies. We're welcoming you into our situations. We're welcoming you into our concerns. We're welcoming you into our challenges. We're welcoming you into our experiences. We're welcoming you, Father God, because we know, Lord, that if you are into it, oh God, we are going to get through it. So we're going to welcome you right now. Oh God, endow us, God. Endow us with your presence. Let your spirit succumb us on tonight, God. Let your glory reign, God. Let your glory reign, God. Oh God, he can't shandela. Let your glory reign, God. Because it's all about you, Lord. It's not about me and birthday, we and us. But it's all about you, God. And we want to put you on a pedestal. Because you are the one that sits on the throne. Oh God, we want to lift you up, God. We want to lift you up, God. We want to lift you up, God. Because you're worthy, Lord. You're worthy, God, and there is none that you'll conceal. There's nobody that can compare either equal to you, God. There's nobody that can stand before you, Lord. There's nobody, Father God, that is greater than you. We bless you, Lord. Oh, God, we bless you right now, God, with the very fruit of our lips. Because you created us to worship you with our lips. You created us with your kosia. Oh, God, for your kosia, for your pleasure. And we're going to give you that sounds good to your ear. We want to be a sweet savor to your nostrils. We want to give you that sound, Father God, that gets your attention. Oh, God, we want to bless you, Lord. We want to bless you, Lord. We want to bless you, Lord. Because you're worthy. Because you're worthy. Because you're worthy and there is none other like you. There is none other like you on all the earth. You are the King of Kings and you are the Lord of Lords. You are great and you are great to be praised. Oh God, and we want to reverence you. We want to give you all the salutations. We want to bow down to you because you are worthy of it. We want to bow down to you as our Lord, our God, our King, our everything. We want to bless you and we want to tell you how much we love you, God. With every muscle and every fiber in our being. We want to get into you right now, God. Because you gave us your precious son. And we want to give you what is due you, God. You have done too much for us, God, for me to sit on my praise. You have done too much for me, God, for me not to worship you. You're worthy, God. You're worthy, God. God, and I'm going to bless you. I'm going to bless you in my home. I'm going to bless you in my car. I'm going to bless you in the land. I'll bless you in the parking lot. I'm going to bless you, Lord, and I dare not be ashamed of you. I dare not be ashamed of you, because you are great, and you are good, and you are marvelous, and you are so sovereign, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh God, I'm gonna give you my best, Father God. It's not gonna be a time that I'm gonna give you my best, because you gave me your best. Oh God, because you are worthy. You are worthy, God. And there is nobody else more worthier than you. Any crown we ever won, we lay at your feet. Any title we ever obtained, we lay at your feet. Any position we ever accomplished, we lay at your feet. Anything that we think that we are, God, we pulling it down right now. Because it's you, God, that is all sovereign and all powerful. It is you, God, that makes it all happen. It is you, God, that open up a door and close it. It is you, God, that speak a thing and it is so. Oh, God, it is you. And we just want to bless you. We want to bless you with the very fruit of our lips. We want to bless you with the clapping of the hands and the stomping of the feet, God. We want the Akasi. I give you my best, God. I give you my Batika Nene Akasi. I give you my best, God, and dedicate my entirety to you, God. Because you are worthy, God. You are so, so worthy, and I love you so, so much. Oh, God, he got little to go see. Because I know, God, that you're not going to change on me. I know, God, that you are not going to walk away from me. I know, God, that you are not going to talk about me, God. I know, God, that you're going to lift up a standard for me. Oh God, and I bless you. I bless you for being God. I bless you for being the same towards me today, yesterday, and forevermore. I bless you on today, God. Oh God, because you're worthy. You're worthy. Oh God, we just want to tell you just how much we love you, God. We may not have told you enough. We may not have told you any today. Simply, I love you, Lord. But we want to do it right now. And if don't nobody else love you, Lord, I love you. If don't nobody else bless you, Lord, I bless you. If don't nobody else praise you, Lord, I praise you. If don't nobody else worship you, God, I'm going to give it to you, God, because you're worthy of it. You're worthy of it, God, and I love you with every muscle and every fiber in my being. And I don't love you just because you do stuff for me, but I love you simply because you're God. You are so sovereign, Lord. And you are so, so faithful towards us. You're so faithful, God, and we just want to bless you. We just want to bless you right now, God. We just want to tell you right now, Father, just how much you mean to us. Oh, God, we want to tell you right now, Father God, in the name of Jesus, because we know that nobody else is greater than you. Nobody else can compare. Nobody else is equal. Lord, you are so sovereign towards us, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Oh God.
The glorious one. Your name.
are so great. You are so great. You are so great, God. There's none like you. In all the earth. God, with the fruit of my lips, I honor you in my body, God.
There is none.
I honor you in my heart and even in my thoughts, God.
You alone are worthy of all.
You are worthy,
God. There's no
other name. Nobody else, God, has the power that your name has. Nobody, Father God, can stand up against you. You are the one to hold all power in your hand. I can't let it go see you. There's none like you, God. There's none like you, God, in all the earth. There's none like you, God, in all the earth. Oh God, we welcome you into this place of tonight, Father God, in the name of Jesus. I'm asking you to cover us in your blood and hide us behind your cross for tonight, Father God. I'm asking you, Father God, in the name of Jesus, that you will go down each and every last one of these pews and meet the needs of your people. You know what each and every individual need, Father God. You know what each and any of you see. I take care of them now. Oh God, you number their hands, God. You know them by their name. Oh God. Oh God. And have your angels in here, Father God, in the name of Jesus. These words north and south from the roof to the very foundation around the entire perimeter. Let your glory swoon your people on tonight, Father God. Let them have an encounter with you, God, that experience of your sovereignty. Oh God, do it. Oh God, do it. I love you so much. Times that we allow so many things to consume us. We be distracted, we be consumed. It be things that causes us to have a strain on our brain. We can't stop thinking about it. We try to work it out and we try to fix it. We try to overturn in our own selves, but I keep telling y'all that the Lord says there's a change coming. Whether it's a good change or whether it's a bad change, it's a change coming, not just in our lives, but in ministry. It's a change coming in the land. It's a change coming on our jobs. It's a change coming concerning our families and our children. It's change, change, change. That's all I hear. You know, sometimes I wonder why things don't happen the way that I think that they should happen. And then the Lord revealed to me on today that it had to happen like that because I saw something way before you saw it. Way before I allowed you to see it. So I had to make sure so you won't have to go through this thing all over again. See, God will try to prepare us. He'll try to prepare us for some stuff. Even in advance. I thank you on tonight, Father God, in the name of Jesus, for the warnings, Lord. I thank you right now, Father God, in the name of Jesus, for even allowing us, Father God, to hear your voice, God, because it's a privilege and it's an honor. Oh, God, I just want to thank you for simply being God. I want to thank you for your peace. I want to thank you for your hope. I want to thank you for your correction. I want to thank you for your instruction. I want to thank you for forgiving us, God. I want to thank you for your direction. I want to thank you on today, Father God, in the name of Jesus, for everything that you are doing right now in our lives, God, because you said now. So right now, he got to move some things out the way. He got to sit some people to the side. He got to bring some people into the function. Oh, God, say he got to do some things. It's a change taking place. Thank you for the change, God. We thank you for giving us a heart of absolutions. We thank you for giving us a heart of forgiveness. We thank you, Father God, for even giving us a heart to seek after your face, Father God, because we want the more of you. I want the more of you, Father God. I don't want nothing more than you, Jesus. Oh, God, I just want you, God. Because I know only you, Father God, will let me know when I'm doing something wrong. Only you, Father God, will let me know, Father God, that you are there when I thought that I was by myself. Only you, Father God, will walk with me, Father God, when other people will stop walking with me, God. Only you, Lord, in the name of Jesus, will embrace me when I need that hug, God. Only you, Father God, got that unconditional love for me. Can't nobody do me like you, God. Ain't nobody qualified in this earth to do me like you do, God. And that's why I give myself unto you in totality. Because you never let me down, God. You never lied to me. You never fooled me, God. And you never left me. You was always there. Even when I was in my darkest moment, God, even, God, when I thought I wasn't going to make it, you was there. You was there telling me I was going to live when the doctor said I was going to die, God. You was there. You was there, Father God, when they said I'd never walk again, Lord. But you allowed me to walk and run, God. You was there. You was there when I didn't have no shelter, God, and I thought everybody would help me because I helped so many people. But Lord, you showed me that it wasn't the people, but it was you, God, that survived it all. You was there, God, when I didn't have no food for me and my soul. You was there, God, you showed me. My provider, God. He was there when I did not have no friends, God, nobody, God. He was there, Lord. He was there all the time, God, when so many people hate me, God. You still love me. You are there. You, God, I love you so much. Lord, when I audio go see, God, you was there. When people walked away from me, God, you are there. Thank you for being there, God. Thank you for being there, God. You never change on me. Thank you. God.
Jesus.
For your consistency in my life.
You are as close.
The least I can do, God, is be consistent and faithful to you, Lord. Oh, God, you have always been here. Jesus, you've been there.
The ever-present help in the time of
you
trouble.
You never, ever left me alone. Oh, God, and we just want to thank you on tonight, Father God, as we reflect on all the things you've done for us. Oh, God, that long road, that road, that road. That road where I think I'm walking alone, God, you are there walking with me, God. Thank you, God.
Glory of the Father.
You are there.
We expect to see the glory.
Oh, God, you get angry with me, but yet you still love Jesus. Me. You are always there.
Jesus, I pray that you would peel back the roof on this place.
So you'll go see.
Jesus, I pray that you would show us your face.
Thank you, Father God, for your faithfulness, God. Thank you for justifying me. Thank you for being my avenger, God. Thank you for giving me a heart of love, even in spite of what people do, what they say, how they act. Thank you, God, for choosing me.
We're not singing about you. We're singing about you.
Oh, God, who don't go see?
We're not singing about you like you're not in the room.
Oh, God, thank you, God. Oh God, we want to reflect on tonight of all the things that you've done for us, God. Thank you for healing my body. Don't nobody know all you healed me from, God. When the doctors gave me a verdict, God, you turned it around. Thank you. Because you hold all power in your hands. Oh God, as we reflect on these things, God.
I just want to pray that we would receive a fresh.
We want to give you a thanksgiving on today.
Jesus.
We want to thank you, Father God, for the raise on our job. We want to thank you for the favor with our supervisors. We want to thank you, Father God, for giving us wisdom to give wealth, God. We want to thank you for the favor with all men, God. We want to thank you for the peace, Father God. We want to thank you, Father God, for everything that you have placed and replaced in our lives, God. We want to thank you for the bad as well as the good, God, because if we did not go through the bad, we would not know that you were so good. Thank you, God.
Getting caught up in the titles and the positions. Forgive us.
Thank you, Jesus.
Charts and the plays and the
thank you, Father God, for the opening and the opportunities that you are allowing your people to have. Thank you for stirring up the gifts on today, God. Thank you for planting us, grounding us, and rooting. Thank you, God,
about the man Christ Jesus.
Thank you for telling us your secrets and revealing your mysteries. We just want to thank you. We just want to thank you. I just want y'all to get yellow sheets of paper and red pens and just start writing down all the stuff that you want to thank God for. Because it seems like I'm the only one in here giving him some thanksgiving. And if I got to do it by myself, I will. Because I'm all right with that. You may be giving them a thanksgiving in your heart. You may be giving him a thanksgiving with a whisper or even a thought. But I can't contain myself. I don't expect for everybody to have the same kind of thanksgiving because we all are individually different. So please understand, I ain't pointing my finger and wagging my head. I'm just telling you that I, Yvette, can't contain myself when it comes to thanking. See, because he done did too much for me. He done did too much for me. I'm telling you. He done did too much for me. I told y'all about the cable bill. And I just want to start the testimonies off right now. Because I can't even hold it in. I keep telling y'all I can't hold it in. So I told y'all about the cable bill. How every month, it's just be amazing to me. I'm like, okay, no. They done sent me another cable bill. But every time I open it up, it just says zero. I owe zero. That is just amazing to me. But let me tell y'all this. I gotta contain myself. God is so gracious toward me. When I tell you, He all blesses me. Now, I told you I only had was with MediaCom for about a week or two. And you know now, because of the pandemic, they don't be wanting you. They don't be asking you for deposits and all that stuff like that. So Y'all know what I'm saying, what can happen to me on today. So I went to the mailbox and I was like, you know what? I don't know what Mika Cobb's sending me a bill for. They probably sending me what I owed them for them 2 weeks. That I had, I don't even think it was 2 weeks, I think it was just a week. So I said, I ain't gonna even look at how many tennis are, because I ain't giving them a dime. Because they was trying to get money from me, and the Lord said, don't tear it, don't open it. I said, okay, and I opened it, and when I opened it, it was a check. They paid me. They gave me a check. I can prove it to you as a number. And I had not gave them a dime. Y'all get it? I'm talking unforeseen blessings. I told y'all this, what, a few weeks ago. I said, every time I go to the mailbox, I be expecting something. I be expecting check. Baby, I got a check in the mail today. Let me tell y'all something about God. He keeps on making a way for me. He keeps on doing things for me. I'm telling you, diligence, consistency, faithfulness out of a pure heart. I preached about all this stuff on Sunday. It gets this attention, baby, and you get rewarded. And I ain't just talking about with stuff. Let me tell y'all about the peace that he will give you even in the midst of the chaos. Baby, he will have you settled. Did you hear what I say? I thank you for the selling meal tonight, God, in all and every area of my life. I thank you, God. Things that used to bother me and used to get there, it don't bother me no more. I'm okay with it. You know, it's a word that they use all the time to say no worries. But it's this word that just been ringing, these words, these three words, that's been ringing in my ears because somebody said it to me. And I can't stop saying it. I'll be like, oh, it's all good. It's all good. It's all good, baby. I wouldn't give a rest. Okay. It's just all good. Everything is good within my soul. Else, baby, but everything is good within my soul. Oh God, I thank you, Lord. I thank you for making it all good for us. Even though we may not see it, even though we may not believe it, God, I believe it. I can see you, God. And I thank you, God. Because there is none like you. In all the earth, God, I thank you for everybody that you have planted in this ministry, God. I thank you for everybody that you positioned in this ministry, Father God. Whether or not they want to accept it, whether they want to run, whether they want to be still, God, or whether they simply want to do absolutely nothing. Oh God, I thank you for it all. I thank you for allowing me, Father God, to govern over your people. You thought I was worthy enough, God. You thought you could trust me. If he could not trust me, he would not even put me here. I thank you for trusting me, God. I won't let you down, Lord. And if by chance I fall into that place, God, help me to see my error. Correct me, God. Oh God, I love you so much. I love you so, 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 so much. There's no way that we can repay you, God, for the things that you have done for us, God. There's no way, Father God, we could give you anything back because it all belongs to you anyhow. But the least we can do is present ourselves as a living sacrifice. Holy God, and acceptable unto you is our job, is our service, Lord. Oh God, we make ourselves available to you on tonight, Father God. We're recommitting ourselves unto you tonight, Father God, in the name of Jesus. And if by chance, Father God, in the name of Jesus, our bodies and our flesh try to make us do something else or try to allow us, Father God, to be lusting after this thing or lusting after that, Father God, I'm asking you right now to give us that power. We need to put it under subjection. Fill us with your Holy Ghost. Remove the scales off our eyes that we can see, uncork our ears that we can hear. Oh God, because we want your glory. We want your glory to subside in us, God, to be around us, God, that everybody that look upon us, they will say, ooh, what church you go to? Who are you? Oh God, let your glory rest upon the lives of your people. Let the evidence be manifested and visible, Father God, even to the unbeliever. Lord, I'm asking you to touch the hearts of your people on tonight, God. Bring back that backslider. Bring back that wayward person. Bring back that person, Father God, that is offended. Bring back that person, Father God, in the name of Jesus, that leads to their own understanding. Bring back that person, Father God, in the name of Jesus, that stiff-necked and even hard-hearted, God, because you said you married to us, God. Oh God, you say nothing will separate your love from us, Father God. Let them know that you love them. Let them know that you are forgiving, God. Oh Lord, I'm asking you to sever any and everything out of our hearts that's not like you, God. Remove any jealousy, enviousness, backbiting, tail barrier, covenant, desirousness, maliciousness, debate, hate. Any bitterness, fornication, masturbation, any vain thing, foul thinking, perverted thinking, any hateful thinking, pointing our finger, wagging our hands. Remove that competitive spirit, that prideful spirit, that haughty spirit, that dainty spirit. Remove that spirit of stubbornness on today, Father God. Oh God, because you said that's witchcraft. You said that's witchcraft. The Bible says that stubbornness is witchcraft. That's what the Bible says. Don't believe me, search the scriptures. Lord, sever that spirit of control and antagonism. Remove that spiteful spirit on today, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Remove any and everything, Father God, out of our lives, from around our lives, and even that's coming near our lives, God, that's preventing us, Father God, from walking in our divine destiny in the fullness of your glory. Reveal the revelation of your word unto your people, God, and even as they read it, get them the understanding that they will not lean to their own understanding. Oh God, I'm asking you to open up some things on today, God. I'm asking you to open up some things on today, God. Expose some things, Father God, even to us individually, our own selves, God, that we will not continue to walk in error, disobedience, Father God, or either rebellion. Oh God, I'm asking you to give us some peace, God. Give us some peace on today, Father God, in the name Jesus, D.O.C. Give us some peace on today, Father God. Let us rejoice with them that rejoice, God. Let us pray with them that need prayer. Oh God, let us confess some things on tonight, Father God, in the name of Jesus, that we may be able to release and be set free, even from our own thoughts, our own minds. Oh God, you have given us your word, Father God. You have spoken your word, Father God, in the name of Jesus. I'm asking you to allow it to be manifest and become fruition in our lives, God, that it will be a complete and total actuality, Father God. Lord, I'm asking you to prepare our hearts to receive our husbands on tonight, God. I'm asking you to prepare us on today, Father God, in the name of Jesus, that we will even have that spirit of tolerance, God. I'm asking you to help us on tonight, Father God, in the name of Jesus, that we will be anxious for nothing and be more patient, God. Lord, I'm asking you to help us on today, Father God, and give us a learning spirit, God, and even a spirit to teach what we have learned. Oh God, I'm asking you to help us on tonight, God. I'm asking you to help us on today, Father God, to forgive one another, Father God. Sever that spirit of offense that we would not feel like we have to defend ourselves. Oh God, I'm asking you to help us on today, God. I'm asking you to allow your spirit to take residence in here, that each and every individual that cross that threshold, Lord, they will even feel your presence. Lord, I'm asking you to even touch the Robinson family on tonight, Father. Touch the Robinson family and even their financial situation, Father God, concerning Mike and the burial. Lord, I'm asking you to do it on tonight, Father God, in the name of Jesus, because I know that you can and will, and I know that you delight in doing so. Oh God, I'm asking you to help your people, God. I'm asking you to help your people to be sustained, Father God, in those very things, Father God, that they think, God, that they cannot obtain. Oh God, I'm asking you to give your people the understanding of the spiritual gifts. Give your people the understanding of the fruits of the Spirit. Give your people the understanding understanding of the Beatitudes. Let your people, Father God, understand these things, Father God, that they will not do what they think that they are doing right, and yet they are doing wrong. I'm asking you to help us on tonight, God. Help us to be complete and whole inside you, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Help us to be complete and whole, Father God, even inside our own lives, God. Let us not have that greedy spirit. Some of that spirit of greed. Some of that spirit of selfishness. Some of that spirit, Father God, of self-righteousness. Some of that judging spirit that we would not put our finger or wag our head. Oh God, some of that silver tongue on tonight, God, that we would not gossip and talk about one another. Help us on today, Father God, in the name of Jesus, that even if we got a problem with one another, let us come to you, God, and then let us go to our brothers and our sisters and get that thing together, because you are God of reconciliation. Oh God, I'm asking you to help us on tonight, God, to tear down the walls and the barriers of defeat. Tear down the walls and the barriers of depression. Tear down the walls and the barriers of lost hope. Tear down the walls and the barriers of poverty. Tear down the walls and the barriers of sickness. Tear down the walls and the barriers of disease. Tear down the walls and the barriers of any and everything, Father God, that's causing us, Father God, to be in a place of division in our homes. A place of division in the church. A place of division in the families. A place of division in the marriages. I'm asking you to sever that spirit on today, Father God, and let there be peace with one another. Oh God, let us embrace one another with love out of a pure heart. Give us pureness in our hearts. Give us pureness in our minds. Let us be true, God. Let us be true unto you, that we may be able to be true unto one another. Oh God, some of that lying spirit, some of that spirit of dishonesty, some of that spirit of manipulation. Let us not be contaminated, Father God, by the communication, Father God, that we keep, by the people and the paper that be around us, Father God. Oh God, I'm asking you to lift us up. Lift us up out of that place, Father God, that we will not cling to the dust. I'm asking you right now, Father God, to complete the work that you've begun in us, God, because it's a great work. Oh God, I'm asking you to help us on today, God, to make sound and right decisions. But the only way we're going to be able to do that, Father God, is if you give us soundness in our minds. So I'm asking you to sever any and every mental disorder. Sever any and every disorder inside of our minds and our thoughts that causes, Father God, to think ill will towards one another. Sever any and every disorder in our minds, Father God, that causes us, Father God, to think evil and wicked towards one another. Oh God, I'm asking you to sever that opinionistic spirit. Sever it right now, Father God, in the name of Jesus, that we will not lean, God, unto the things that we think concerning our own opinion. Oh God, help us perceive things the way that you do through your visual lenses, and not our own, God, because our visual lenses, Father God, they tend to contaminate our thoughts, and then it trickle down to our hearts. Circumcise our hearts on tonight, Father God. Let our hearts be not just pure, but circumcise and remove all the black spots. Remove all the doubt. Remove all the hate. Remove all the resentment. Remove all the bitterness. Oh God, sever the spirit of covetousness on tonight, Father God. Oh God, because we just want you. I just want you. Make it personal. I just want you. Oh God, let your will be done within our lives, Father God. I'm asking you to touch Miss Daisy on tonight, God. Even as she lay up in the hospital, regulate her blood pressure. And whatever it is that's going on with it, God, you are the only one that can elevate it or even deflate it. Whatever it is, God, let your will be done. And even touch her son and even her daughter-in-law, Father God, that they may have the strength to accept some things, Father God, that's going to transpire in their lives. Oh God, I'm asking you to cover them on tonight. Cover right now, Father God, in the name of Jesus. I'm asking you to touch Jerry Gardner Sr. on today, Father God. Touch him in his eyes, God. Heal his eyes on tonight, Father God. Because you know any and everything that's going on with him, God. You know any and everything that he fear. Sever that spirit of fear on tonight, Father God, in the name of Jesus. The fear of going blind. The fear of being crippled. Help him on tonight, Father God. And I'm asking you to make him whole. Because I know that you are able and you are even capable. I know that you can do it, God. And I'm standing in the gap for that family. Touch even his wife, Sandra, God. Sever that spirit of fear on her, Father God. Even concerning the brain tumors that she has in her head, God. I'm asking you to remove them. I'm asking you to give her some stability, Father God, that she will not fear, God, that she is going to do this or do that, or this or that is going to happen. But let her lean and trust in you, God. Touch the children, Father God. Touch about cutting even Jerry, Father God. Even as they try to hold their mother and their father up during this trying time. Give them the strength that they need, Father God, that they could continue to encourage them. And they could continue to pray for them. And they will continue to stand in the gap for them. Oh God, I'm asking you to do it on tonight, God. Because I know that you can. Oh God, I'm asking you to touch your people, God. Touch our face on tonight, Father God. Let your will be done within our life, God. Remove the grief and the sorrow, God, out of the death of her loved one, Father God, that she will know, Father God, that you are truly a comforter. Oh God, I'm asking you to endow her with it, God. Let her not regret or feel like she's doing something wrong because she cannot be here. Cover her while she is out of the country, God. Give her your peace, give her your protection, and direct her footsteps. Let your will be done within her life, God. And I'm asking you even now, God, to touch India on tonight, God. Cover your blood and hide her behind your cross. Give her your strength and give her your peace. Regulate any blood disorders on tonight, God. Regulate that sugar disorder. Regulate that blood pressure disorder. Regulate that leukemia disorder. Oh God, I'm asking you to touch right now, God. I'm asking you to touch right now, Father God, and sever blood cancer. Remove it right now. I just saw cancer in the blood. Sever it right now, God, in the name of Jesus. I know that you are able. Give your people blood transfusion. Let them have your blood, God. Oh God, give them a blood transfusion. Let your blood heal. Let your blood deliver. Let your blood set free. And let your blood make whole. Oh God, I'm asking you to touch Mama Carol on tonight, God. Touch any variables of her belly. And every cancer cell that's trying to enter into her body and sack her bowels, God. I'm asking you to remove it on tonight. I'm asking you to subside it on tonight, God, because she's tired of being in pain. I'm asking you to help her not to continue to exalt these things over you, God, because she know who you is. But Father God, the pain had a tendency of letting her forget what you are able to do. Oh God, I'm asking you to do it on today. You said that you wanted us to have life and have it in abundance. You want us to prosper even as our soul prosper, and you even want us to be in good health. I'm asking you to let your people to be in good health, Father God. You say that you will preserve our flesh and fatten our bones. I'm asking you right now, Father God, to remove any sickness and disease out of the marrow and the bones. I'm asking you to do it on tonight, God. Touch our kidneys, Father God. Remove the hardness in the kidneys. Purify the kidneys on tonight, God. Purify the liver, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Restore your people, God. Restore them back into perfect health. Restore your people on today, God. I command that even asthma in the respiratory system, bronchitis, lung disease, lung disorder, anything in the respiratory system. Oh God, I'm asking you to breathe a fresh breath into your people, breathe a new life into your people, Father God, and let them know, Lord, that you are the breath of life. Oh God, I'm asking you to do it, God. I'm asking you to do it because I know that you are able. I'm asking you to do it on today, God. I'm asking you to go into the bodies and touch the lymph nodes, Father God, and let not any disorders come up into the lymph nodes. I suffer breast cancer right now, in the name of Jesus. Come, God, cover us with your blood, because you said by your stripes we are healed. And I believe you, Father God. Heal your people in the mind, heal them in the body, heal them in the hearts, heal them, Father God, in their internal organs. Touch the heart on today, Father God, and unclog any arteries. Oh God, any arrhythmia, that is a disorder in the heartbeat. Touch right now, Father God. Let it be a steady beat, because you are the one, Father God, in the name of Jesus, that allow all these things to take place in our bodies. Oh God, I'm asking you to sever that spirit of greed, overeating. Oh God, eating as a comfort food, causing us, Father God, to be overweight. Causing us, Father God, in the name of Jesus, that Dio goes something like I see, to be unhealthy. Help us on today, God, with our salt intake, that we will not crave salt, causing our bodies, Father God, to carry extra fluid. Level down our body on today, God. Removing excess water, removing excess fluid, Father God, even from traveling up to our lungs and hearts and drowning us, God. Touch us in our minds on today, Father God, and remove and heal cerebral palsy. Touch us in our minds on tonight, God, and remove and heal any and everything that causes us, Father God, to be afflicted in our extremities. Help us on tonight, Father God. I know that you are able. I know that you are able. And I'm standing on your word because I know that you are able. I know what you did for me. Oh God, you straightened out my legs. You straightened out my arms, God. You allowed me to stand up straight and walk on my own. I did not need no support when they said that I was going to have to. Oh God, I just want to thank you. I know you are able, God, to remove any crutches and any walkers and any wheelchairs. I know you are able, Father God, in the name of Jesus, to heal HIV, to heal cancer, to heal any and every disease, Father God, that's in the land. Because you are the one, Father God, that has allowed it to come into the land. Oh God, and we want to thank you, God, that you may be able to get the glory. We want to thank you, God, because it is your glory. We want to thank you, God, even for the death. We want to thank you for the death of things. We want to thank you for killing things. We want to thank you, Father God. Thank you, God. Oh God, we just want to thank you. We just want to thank you on today, God. Sever that spirit of complaining. Sever right now, Father God, in the name of Jesus, that your people will be simply content with what they got. Grateful for what they already have. Oh God, because it could be worse. Oh God, and we just want to glorify you on today. We want to glorify you, and we want to lift you up, and we want to thank you, Father. We want to thank you even in advance for what you are about to do in our lives. We want to thank you for most definitely what you're doing in our lives right now. We want to thank you right now, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, for the manifestation of your glory. We just want to thank you on tonight. We just want to thank you on tonight, Father God, in the name of Jesus. And we want to tell you how much we love you, how much we adore you, and how much we appreciate you. We want to thank you right now, Father God, even for healing us in our minds. We thank you for the stability in our minds and even in our thoughts, Father God, that we are not lunatics. Oh God, we want to thank you, God, for the solidity in our minds. Oh God, we just want to thank you right now, God, as we write down these things that we are thankful for. As we give you these things, Father God, that we are most thankful for, Father God. We just want to give you all the salutations. We want to give you all the glory. And we want to give you all the honor, God, because you are worthy. And we ask you to not just consider, we ask you to honor these prayers on tonight, Father God. In your son Jesus' name. Amen, amen, and amen. Everybody, yellow sheets of paper and red pens to write down everything that you are thankful for. We're not going to write down anything else because we're not going to exalt anything higher than God. So if you wrote down something on that paper that you want from God, or if you wrote something down on that paper that you need him to do for you, I want you to put it in your purse and bring it Sunday. Tonight, the only thing that we write down is what we are giving God thanks for. We want to be thankful on tonight. We want to be thankful on tonight. It's testimony time. I already started giving my testimony. So I'm going to open up the floors and give you guys an opportunity to give a testimony or even testify. And I know it's something that somebody and everybody got to say about that man called Jesus. You can testify, which is giving God thanks and letting him know what he means to you. Or you can give a testimony, and that's simply to tell your story of what's going on and what he has done for you. Because the Bible declares that we are overcome by our testimonies. Our testimonies will help somebody else that is discouraged and thinking that they can't get out or they can't get away. But we just want to thank God for everything that he is doing, good or bad. And whether or not we think and believe that that thing is at a bad state, I told y'all that change is coming. And everything that is happening now in our lives, it has to happen for something else to happen. And I just want to thank God for what's happening. Everything that's happening in our lives now, it has to happen in order for something else to happen. And I want to thank God for what's happening. I'm going to say it one more time. Everything that's happening in our lives right now, it has to happen in order for something else to happen. And I'm going to thank God for what's happening. Right now. Y'all get it one more time. Everything that's happening in our lives right now, it has to happen like that now. in order for something else to happen now. So I'm going to thank him for what's happening now, that we're now. I just want to thank you, Lord. Just scream loud as y'all can. Thank you, God. Come on, loud. Go.
Thank you, God.
I just want to thank you, God. I just want to thank you, God, for what's happening now. So write down all these things. The floors are open. Is there but one person that want to give a testimony of the goodness of God? Is there but one person that just simply want to thank God? Is there anybody that want to open up their mouths and give a testimony? The floor is open for you guys. If you want to sing, if you want to holler, if you want to run, if you want to jump, whatever you want to do, the floor is open. Is there but one person? Is there but one person?
Right, you said we can sing, I'm gonna sing. I got a few things I want to share. First, I want to just thank God. I thank God for who he is within our life. I thank him for everything that he's doing right now and everything that is happening, just like God said, because it all has to happen for a reason. Last week, I had to go get a tire replaced. And in the midst of getting that tire replaced, I knew something was wrong, but I did not know exactly what. So after I left the tire place, where I left the front, and they showed me, I asked the gentleman, did he see which one it was? Because I was thinking it was one of the ones I had not replaced, which was only one. And when he told me, he said, no, it was the one on my passenger side in the back, which I had already gotten changed, because that one had already previously blown out on me, which God kept me covered in that one as well. Well, this time there was a split down the left side of the tire, and it was just like ripping. And he said when inside the tire, it was a lump on it when it was blown up. He's like, that tire could have caused a blowout. I got a picture of it. That's what I want to show you. I said, oh Lord, I thank you. I thank God every time that I got on that interstate and I was like, Lord, just cover my car. I said, hold it together, Lord, because I don't know what's going on, but you do. So you control the universe, control this car. And he kept it until I got it changed. And every time I would go to get on the interstate some days and it would be raining or whatever, he would be like, just take the streetway, just take your time. You'll get to where you need to get to. And I'll let whoever know where I'm going. Look, I'm taking the streetway, I'm on the way. So I just really thank God for continuously covering me, even when I don't know what lies ahead. I thank him for allowing us to pray those prayers every morning, praying for covering and keeping us safe from our hurt, harm, and anything seen and unseen, because that was something unseen and unknown that I was not aware was there. That could have caused something, but it did not. And I thank him for keeping me in that. And I also want to thank him. I thank him for altering my perspective all this week. He has been allowing me to look at things in a different light and even be able to go to certain people and say certain things to them that I would have not said before. Apologize, and just to apologize, asking for forgiveness, just really like clearing my heart of some things and my mind of some things. And I thank God for that. I thank him for the sermons that he allows to be taught on Sundays, because it gives us tools, it gives us knowledge. It gives us a formula to be able to go home and use, to be able to apply to our everyday life. On this morning, I woke up to get on the prayer line. And in the midst of it, you know, I usually get on there a little early. When I got on there this morning, my phone was off. And I said, okay, Lord. Now, any other time, I'd be all frantic in the panic. I'd pull my hair out, but I said, okay. I said, Lord, I'm just going to do what I know to do best, and I'm going to let you work the rest of it out. So I got on my cell phone, and I got on the prayer line, and I did not allow that thing to keep me from doing what he asked me to do. Because I could have just said, my phone ain't on, I ain't going to do it. And like I said, being stubborn about it. But I said, no, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to get on this prayer line, and I'm going to pray, and I'm going to let God just do whatever he got to do this morning. So after we got done, I used my cell phone to call and make the calls I need to make. And I couldn't figure out why I couldn't make the arrangements from my phone, because it was connected to the internet. And the lady I spoke to, her name is Tiffany, she was so sweet. Now she said, well, go turn your data on. I said, well, ma'am, it's on. I said, my Wi-Fi on. She said, well, go check it one more time and do it while I'm on the phone with you. So I went to look at it, but I went to my settings instead of doing it from my toolbar. And I went to it and I clicked on it. I said, oh, I said, it wasn't connected all the way. I said, well, thank you for, you know, redirecting me in that. Instead of getting the attitude and telling her, my wife I own and, you know, looking at it the wrong way. So she said, I don't want you to be charged these extra fees when you can just do it from your app. Yet again, that's another blessing. She could have just did that for me and I would have had to pay that extra $10, but she didn't. So she said, go to your app and do it. And it was not loading. And I said, I don't know what's wrong with this thing. I said, it's not loading. So she said, click out of it and go back in. So when she walked with it, she was patient with me. We were greeting each other. She was kind. We were just exchanging, you know, kind words with each other. And it was a pleasant customer call because usually the people be snotty. And sometimes we be snotty. But I be trying my best because I know they got to take them calls all day. And after we made the payment arrangements, everything reconnected, got some extra extension time to pay the bill. And she greeted me about my day, and I greeted her about her day, and we thanked each other. And I just thank God because in that moment, I could have went the wrong way, I could have had a wrong attitude, but I've been praying and asking God to alter my perspective the way that I have been looking at things so that I can approach them in the right way. Because I know sometimes when we look at stuff with our natural eyes, when we hear things with our natural ears, we just let the flesh take over. So I've been really trying to practice not letting my flesh take over. And he has really been helping me to do that. So I thank God this week. He just been teaching me all kinds of stuff. Even in the midst of correction, he still was kind and sweet to me. And it still allowed me to know that, you know, don't be all messed up and in your feelings about it. I'm just trying to let you know what happened so that, you know, you can learn. Because if I didn't tell you, how would you know? And in that moment, I had to sit on my bed and think. I was like, okay, Lord. I say, well, Lord, I thank you for teaching me. I thank you for showing me because I didn't know. And if you didn't tell me, I would still be thinking, even though I felt it was right. It was right from my perspective, but it wasn't the way that you wanted to be done. So thank you, Lord, so that, you know, I could do it right the next time. So I just want to thank God for even just teaching me on this weekend, even allowing me to speak encouraging words to people, from allowing my experiences that I went through to be able to minister to someone else. I was talking to a gentleman today, and everything that pastor was saying about, you know, your heart and all that, not let things get to you. I just ministered that same thing to this gentleman about not letting what happened to him in his past cause his heart to be hard. Everything happens for a reason. I was like, you know, don't let your heart be closed because of the experience with that marriage. I said, you never know. God will put your angel in your path, and because your heart is closed and you looking at it because of what she did, you're going to miss your blessing. I was like, don't do that. He was like, yeah, you're right. I said, but it's okay. I said, I'm learning too still. He said, me too. I'm going to get that lesson one day. I said, it's okay. I'm still getting them lessons, so it's all right. I said, if you ever want to call and pray and talk about it, just call me. But I said, I understand. I said, we all have been through some relationships, and he was talking about, you know, being the way he was treated or being done. I said, well, and staying somewhere too long where you don't belong. I said, huh. I said, I can tell you about that too. I said, don't feel bad. It's okay. I said, but I have learned that it's all for a reason. And even though it did not feel good when we experienced it, it was to teach us so that we can grow. That even in that moment that we'll know, you know, how to handle things better next time, how we'll be able to see and not ignore our warnings and our red flags God gives us. So I just thank him for teaching me and allowing me to be able to teach somebody else in the midst of even the experiences that I've gone through. Because I did not embrace those things before, but now I'm learning to embrace those things because they have helped me grow. They have helped me become who I am even the more, and even allow myself to just learn who I am. Because there was a time that I couldn't even say, you know, who I am, what I like to do, you know, what things that I enjoy. If you ask me, who am I? You know, that's a question that we were asked in one of our women's forum on top of our paper, who am I? And now when I look at that paper, I can write a slew of things of who am I. So I just thank God for being who he is within my life, because it has been life-changing, life-altering. So, Lord, I thank you.
Is there anybody else that want to give a testimony? They want to testify. They want to talk of the goodness of God. But they simply just want to share something about what God is doing. Because he is great.
I just want to say thank you.
I just want to say thank you for allowing me to get up every morning and get to work. One of the things that the Lord told me to do is that I need to walk more. And so I just want to thank the Lord for allowing me to walk more every day. I want to thank the Lord for the blessing me and on my job and blessing me with a raise. I want to thank the Lord for providing for me in spite of me. I want to thank the Lord. I just want to say thank you.
You've got to go.
I was just thinking about how when I walked to work, I was talking about how this one vehicle, it's the same vehicle, seemed like they always want to run me off the road. But when I'm walking down the road right now, people are going around me. So I just want to thank God for that. I want to thank Him for giving me safe travels while I'm walking. I want to thank Him for opening up my eyes and allow me to see that I can take the bus. I just have to, the bus, I just have to walk a little way. So I thank the Lord that every pain that I feel when I'm walking, because when it's done and over with, God be feeling good. So things happen for a reason. I want to thank the Lord that, you know, Pastor told me it was just water, but that's 30 pounds of water that's been off my body. And I want to thank Him for that. I want to thank Him for that. I want to thank Him for His mercy and that He keeps on working with me. He keeps on and keeps on and keeps on. And I know that we are abusers, or I'm an abuser, but I just want to thank Him. I just want to thank Him. There are times when I'll be like, I don't know how I'm going to take care of something. And it all works out. A bill, I could call and make arrangements and then the money come in. Or I don't know where the money going to come from. And then all of a sudden, like, well, where did this come from? You know, it just works out. It may not work out exactly when I want it to, but it just works out. And I just want to say thank you. I want to thank Him for that. I just want to thank Him. And the last couple of days has been a struggle in my mind. But I actually was trying. And I want to thank God just for that little bit of trying. That little bit of push that I've had, knowing that I don't have to stay. I want to thank the Lord because I was sitting there and I was just looking at the scriptures and He was just showing me, you know, the scripture 24:1, the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, the world and they that dwell therein. And I was sitting there and the enemy had me thinking that I didn't belong to the Lord anymore. And I just want to thank the Lord because He showed me everything belongs. I don't know how and where I got messed up like that. But everything, even Satan, everything belongs to Him. Everything belongs to Him. I want to thank the Lord for holding back the creditors. Oh my gosh.
You are the screen.
I just want to thank the Lord because I sit there and think about what I owe, but they're not knocking on my door. And I just want to thank the Lord that mercy and that grace. I just want to thank Him for that. I just want to thank Him for that. I just want to thank Him for that I'm here. I thank Him for the ride to church tonight. Thank you. I want to thank Him for the food.
I want to thank him for the food that's given to me, the food that I could buy. Jesus. I want to thank him for that. I want to thank him that when I look at myself with my hair cut like this, I don't look at myself and say I'm ugly.
Thank you.
I just want to thank him for that. I just want to appreciate him and thank God. When I got a ride from Pastor Dyke, she was praising, but I actually was sitting in my chair and I actually had a praise in my heart. I hadn't had a praise in my heart in a long time. So I just want to thank him for even that little bit of praise. Just that little bit. I just thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Thank you. I want to thank him. When I come home, when it was storming, I got caught in the storm, but I was okay.
Thank you.
The lightning struck me, man, and that stuff was loud, and you could tell when it was close. But it didn't hit me.
Thank you.
And then other times, my co-worker offered to take me home. I just want to thank him.
Thank you.
I want to thank him for that.
Thank you.
I thank you, Lord. I thank you for that. I have my right mind right now. I thank you that I have my right mind right now.
Thank you.
Thank you. Change has to come. I just believe. So I just want to thank God for at least helping me to see a little bit more than what I was yesterday. I thank God for the stripping. To help us see who we are and the mess we are in. I just wanted to thank him tonight. Because I just been noticing some things and I wanted him to know that I appreciate him.
That's just like God. He keep on doing it. He keep on making a way for us when we think there's no way. Lord, I'm asking you to touch even the housing situation, God, because I see some things in the atmosphere concerning your people and the housing situation. So, Lord, I'm asking you to touch that thing right now because it's some people that need housing, God. It's some people that need to get away from certain kind of housing, God. It's some people, Father God, that's in expectation for housing. Whatever the case may be, Father God, concerning their living situation, Lord, I'm asking you to touch touch and ensure your people favor. I'm standing in a gap form right now, Father God, in the name of Jesus, because I know that you are able to do exceedingly abundantly above all we can ask, think, or even imagine. So I'm asking you to touch it right now, Father God. I'm asking you to restore your people back into their proper positions, in their places, Father God, in you, God. And let not nothing, Father God, regardless to what they think, what they feel, what they're going through, what people say, how they act, turn from you ever again, God. I'm asking you to ground root and stabilize your people, Father God, that they will not only come to you, Father God, and make petitions, but they will come to you and simply give you their appreciation, Father God, for simply what they're going through, whether it's good or bad. Oh God, we want to thank you. We want to thank you, Father God, for that mercy you give us brand new every day. We want to thank you, Lord, for that grace that you give us that we do not even deserve. We want to thank you for placing and replacing, removing, and even giving us things, Father God, that we thought that we could not even obtain. We want to thank you even for the new cars, God. We are in expectation for the new houses. We are in expectation for the husbands that we are in expectation for, the wives that we are in expectation for. Lord, I'm standing in the gap for the men, the women, the children, God. I'm standing in the gap for everybody, God. Serving that abusive spirit in the marriages, serving that abusive spirit even in the homes, and we even abuse our own selves. The Lord said we abuse our own selves. Some of that spirit of us abusing our own selves and our thoughts and our minds, God. Lift your people up on today, God. And we're going to thank you in advance for what you are about to do in our lives, God. We just want to thank you, Father God, even for severing that lazy spirit, God. We want to thank you right now, Father God, for even severing that spirit of wanting to give up, Lord. We want to thank you for the newness in our bodies. We, in your son Jesus' name, amen. Remember, I want you guys to write down any and everything that you are thankful for on that yellow sheet of paper. And keep in mind, whatever it is, it could be worse. So thank him even for the little. Thank him even for the little. Thank him for the bad as well as good. Because let me tell you something, in me is so subtle, so cunning, and so subtle. You know he could, if he could talk angels out of heaven, don't you know he could talk you into hell? I mean, think about it. If he could convince some angels to do everything contrary to what God had already taught them to do, because they are angels, don't you know he would convince you to do everything that's contrary to what God want you to do? Come on, people. I love you guys so very much. I'm going to give you time to write down the rest of these things, because I see people writing. Because it always comes back to our mind. Oh, I forgot to thank him for this. Oh, I forgot to thank him for that. So just write down everything that you want to thank him for. And the next voice that you're going to hear is going to be the voice of our speaker tonight. And that'll be our very own Lisa Cochran. So please, let's give her a hand in advance. Everybody that has wrote down anything already, please come and bring it up to the altar. And when you bring it up to the altar and you put it on there, after you get through writing down all this stuff, take your time. Then, when you bring it up here, I want you to just stop for a few and pray concerning that thing that you're putting on the altar. And the only thing that you're putting on the altar tonight is thanksgiving unto God. That's the only thing that you're putting on the altar. If you want God to do something or anything else for you, write it down on a yellow sheet of paper, red pen, or put it in your pocketbook and bring it to church on Sunday and put it on the altar then. Tonight, the altar is simply only for thanksgiving, you guys. Remember, when you bring it up here, stop, pray about it, and give him that thanksgiving that he deserves.
Your tender mercy. Yeah. So I looked it up, and as I looked it up, I looked at the definitions of it, and I looked for the biblical meaning, and I looked at the natural meaning of what it gave us. And even in me looking at the definitions of it, they still were intertwined with each other, but at the same time, they still had two different definitions. So the definition of worry is to give way to anxiety or unease. Allow one's mind to dwell on difficulties or troubles. To be concerned, be anxious, agonize, brood, dwell, panic, get in panic, lose sleep, get worked up, get in a fluster. All those things that cause us not to be settled in our minds. So then I looked up concern. Concern was, says to relate to be about. cover retreat have to deal with, discuss, go into, study? That was a verbal meeting. Now, it's anxiety and worry in the same words. Like, what's another word for concern? Care, anxiety, solicitude, and worry. It said, does concern mean care? And I was just going through, just trying to see, okay, are they the same or are they different? And what I do remember when I wrote down, when I looked it up, that worry was leading to a place of anxiety, to be unsettled, to be expecting the unexpected, to look for trouble. But when you're concerned about something, you're looking at the situation, but it's not taking you to a place of anxiety and not being settled. You know the thing is coming, but, yeah, I know. I would be dealing with me about that, not to worry. But concern is just caring about that thing. You want the best outcome from it. You're not looking at it in the wrong perspective. And I was like, okay, Lord. And that's something that he's always dealing with me about. He's always having pastor to tell me not to worry my pretty little head, not to get all worked up, not to be anxious. And I'm like, okay, Lord, help me not to be anxious in my spirit. And I'm always praying that now. And just like this morning, like I gave the example, my phone got cut off. I was not in a place to worry. I was concerned because I was trying to get on the prayer line. But at the same time, I had a solution. And I also knew that if I could get connected to customer service, I could make those payment arrangements that I needed to make. So it did not make me all discombobulated and messed up in my mind and crying and pulling my hair out like I used to be, because I used to be sitting rocking in a cone trying to figure out how I was going to get paid. But I didn't. So that's what he gave me for that. And also, I wanted to make sure I had a scripture to go with it. I did not want to just go into it and, you know, not search the scripture, because he always say, tell me to search the scripture. So in Matthew 6 and 25. 6 and chapter 25, I'm sorry. It says, therefore I say unto you, take no thought for your life, what ye shall eat or what ye shall drink, nor yet for your body, what ye shall put on. Is not the life more than meat, and the body than raiment? Behold the fowls of the air, for they sow not, neither do they reap, nor gather into barns. Yet your heavenly Father feedeth them. Are ye not much better than they? Which of you by taking thought can add one cubit unto his stature? And why take ye thought for raiment? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow. They toil not, neither do they spin. And yet I say unto you, that even Solomon all his glory was not arrayed like one of these. Wherefore, if God so clothe the grass of the field, which today is, and tomorrow is cast into the oven, shall he not much more clothe you, O ye of little faith? Therefore take no thought, saying, what shall we eat, or what shall we drink, or wherewithal shall we be clothed? For after all these things do the Gentiles seek. For your heavenly Father knoweth that ye have need of all these things. But seek ye the first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. Take therefore no thought for the morrow, for the morrow shall take thought for the things of itself. Sufficient unto the day is the evil thereof. So, that's what he gave me on that. I had to find a scripture to go with it, because I was like, I want to understand, and I've been asking God to teach me. So I had to go and search to find that, and not just take the one scripture, because pastor always teaches us to read everything that goes with it, because it's more to it. So I wanted to also share that when he gave it to him, because I know a lot of times we're in a place of worry, and we're not supposed to worry, but us as being human beings is something that, you know, has been embedded in us. And even though we know God is going to take care of that thing, when we look at it with our natural eyes, it causes us to get miscombobulated. But we look at it spiritually, and it's like the scripture said, if God provided for the animals and the grass and all that, he'll take care of us and provide all our needs. So I've learned to alter my prayer and say, Lord, I know you already know my needs, but I'm submitting my request to you, and I'm letting you know that I see this thing and you know what I need. So I'm asking you to just make way for me and keep me calm till you prepare for me, because I know you're going to handle it. So he has really been teaching me not to worry about a lot of things within life, and just to let him be who he is. On Saturday, I did noon prayer, and it's a song that came on, Let Go and Let God Have His Way. And I just could not get myself together to get into prayer. So I just let the song play, and the Spirit just took over. And just like he said, let go and let God have his way. As soon as you start worrying and things start happening, when you let God do what he need to do within your life, and he really has. When I start worrying about how this gonna get paid, how that gonna get paid, the stuff get paid, what stuff gonna come from, and I be like, okay, Lord, help me not to worry, and just do what you got to do. I say it just like that. They say talk to him like he a real person in your face. I be like, all right, Lord, do what you got to do, because I already know you in control. I don't know what to do, and you do, so okay, do whatever it is, and he make it happen, and he keep making it happen, and he keep making it happen some more, and just a little bit more, and I just thank God for just getting me to this place. I got some more work to do, but I am in a different place than I was. Also, he gave me today self-love. I was like, okay, so what's this self-love thing? I was searching for scriptures, but nothing connected to me. So I just feel like he wanted us to discuss it, because he's having us on the prayer line to pray for our self-esteem, our self-image, to love on ourselves. So we all have to learn how to, like he just said, look in the mirror and like what we see. And when she said that, I said, he got her all up in my notes, but my notes right here. But I got self-love written on this paper. And learning to love yourself is what I know a lot of us are learning to do, because of the things that we have gone through, the experiences, the relationships, the heartache and the heartbreaks, and being able to go back into the mirror and look at ourselves and know who we are. And I know for me, God has been reminding me daily who I am. He always has pastors tell me that I am a gem and like a diamond. And I was sitting here earlier today, and he was showing me that again. I was like, Lord, thank you for reminding me who I am, for building my self-esteem up, and just teaching me how to love myself again, because you lose yourself going through things and being a mom, being a wife, and jobs, and being who you are, in positions that you are placed in. You really don't have time or feel like you have time to focus on yourself. And I think that he wants us to do more of that. And in loving on ourselves is also, I remember reading, loving on him. When we love on him, he can teach us how to love ourselves. And we'll be able to love on other people. And when we love on other people the right way, because we love on ourselves the right way, we'll have the right perspective. We won't get upset when they do a thing, because we got the love God gave us in our heart, that we'll be able to forgive and look past the things that they are doing. And also, and learn to love on ourselves. We won't just accept any and everything. We won't settle. We won't compromise. We'll know that God has already told us that we're valuable. And we are valuable. We're not going to take no dirt and no crumbs, you know, out the bottom of somebody's shoe. We're going to wait till he fixes our plate at the table with our golden plates and silverware like we're supposed to. So I was like, okay, Lord, thank you for that. I thank God for even just allowing us to be able to beautify ourselves. That's your self-image. When you look good, you feel good. And when you feel good on the outside and you feel good on the inside, that is the most wonderful feeling ever. Just remembering a time where I did look in the mirror and I was like, who is that? It's like I had blurred vision. And that's when I first started coming to the church, and I had mornings where I look up and it was just like, I could not find my smile. My mom was like, you lost your smile. You used to smile. And I was like, I don't know. It was just so much going on. And God was really altering my life so much. And I was trying to find that balance again. But once he gave me that balance back, when I look in the mirror, I'm like, okay, girl, you cute. You know, that's a nice outfit. Okay, go ahead, hell. I'll be, you know, hyping myself up. I'm finding myself again. And it's a great feeling, because going through the things you go through, trying to be a mom, trying to be strong for everybody else, and You just lose yourself. Even in the midst of relationships that you go through, the things that people say to you, plant those seeds, and you're looking at yourself and asking, am I really that? When in actuality, that person said it to you because that's how they feel about themselves. So they're projecting that thing onto you. Now they planted that seed, and now you're looking at yourself in the wrong way, when that's not who you are. And even if you may be that, when God says you are who you are, that's who you are. It's not what you say or what you have going through. It is who you're becoming. You have to embrace that change and not front up against it, because we're going to all go through those things. And I always identify with the butterfly going through changes. Everybody know I love butterflies, how they go from the caterpillar and go in the cocoon and come out transformed with these beautiful wings and all these colors and stuff. And that's how it always comes across to me. And every time I meet somebody, they always wind up saying something to me about a butterfly. And I just feel like that'd be God talking to me, like, you transforming. You're going through those transformations. So I thank God for taking us through the transformations, for teaching us self-love, and to teach us how to love on him, that we can love on ourselves, because the more that we love on him, he will direct us. He'll tell us what we need to do in which area. He'll show us what it is that we need to work on. He'll even tell us what things that we need to do to even, you know, love on ourselves, so that we'll feel that, so that we won't look for that in things, people, and places, and we'll get it from the source where we're supposed to get it from. So I just thank God for his teachings. It has been so enlightening for him to place these things on my heart and even be able to share them, and even removing shame and embarrassment so that I can speak about these things. Because there was a time where I was like, I'm not going to tell these folks my business. If the Lord don't show it to them, they ain't going to know. But he has been removing it, and I'm able to speak it. It don't make me crack in my throat no more. So I just want to thank God for his love, that I am able to love me and love the people around me the right way. And that love transforms your heart to a heart of forgiveness. And I thank God for the forgiveness in my heart. And it just has been truly an amazing transformation. So, Lord, I thank you. And that's all I have. You know, he gave it to me short and sweet. So, thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for that word. There's so many times that we always, and I got to say this, we always hold on to stuff. And we don't ever let it go. We worry. We just worry too much. We worry about what that people saying, what people saying about us, what they think about us. We worry about if we accepted or if we ain't accepted. We worry about if they love us or if they don't. We worry about if they cheating or if they ain't. We worry about if I can get this or can I have that. We worry about this. We worry about how we look and how other people look at us. We worrying about so much. But this song right here says it perfect. And I'm just going to start it all over with. We just got to put our worries to God. So I want y'all to write down all y'all worries right now. And I told y'all already. And instead of putting them on the altar, I want y'all to put them in the prayer box. Okay? As I pray for you guys, I want y'all to write down y'all worries and y'all concerns. Stuff start happening and things start triggering. What you say, it starts to alter. Things start to alter when you let go and you simply just let God. Thank you, Jesus, for letting us realize that we need to let go and let you do what you do. We need to stop being us. Don't you be you so God can be God. You let go and you just let God. You can't do nothing about Miss Daisy Health. You got to let go and let God. So why worry about it? Let it go. Like Frozen. Let it go, let it go. My little granddaughter got me singing, let it go. I'm Frozen. What the world? So just let go. You can't do nothing about that car situation. Let it go and let God. You can't do nothing about that situation and this situation. You can't make nobody talk to nobody else. Let go and let God. We worried about the wrong stuff. You can't make nobody love you. You can't make nobody talk to you. You can't make nobody embrace you. You can't stop worrying about that little stuff. Let go and let God. Let go and let God handle that situation. Handle that person. Handle that concern. Let go and let God work that thing out on your job, in your home, in your families, in your marriages, in your bodies. Let go and let God. Lord, as we write these things down, Father God, in the name of Jesus, we want to let go and let you. Come pray, Lisa. You spoke it. Come pray about it for the people. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We gotta let go and let God. We gonna let go and let God. We just gotta let go and let God do some things. We gotta let go and let God handle some things. That's what we gotta do. Thank you, Jesus.
We just thank you right now. Thank you, Father God, for always showing up, Father God. For always being right in front of us, Father God. And now it's time to be, Father God. And now it's time to worry, Father God. And now it's time to feel, Father God. We thank you, Father God. Lord, I'm asking right now, Father God, to touch our hearts, to touch our minds, Father God. And help us, Father God, to let go, Father God. And allow you to have your way, Lord God. Father God, I'm asking right now, you touch every worry and every concern, Father God. Every problem, Father God. Every challenge that we may face, Father God. Every situation, Father God, that we don't have the answer, Lord God, we're sitting and pondering how we're going to get that thing done, Lord. I'm asking that you remove it right now in the name of Jesus, Lord God. I'm asking, Father God, that situation between our loved ones, Lord God, that you would step on in, Father God, that you would be obedient, Lord God. I'm asking, Father God, that you remove that worry and that concern that we may have, Father God. We want to see our family come together, Father God, and not be split apart, Lord. I'm asking, Father God, that you would step in, Lord God. I'm asking, Father God, you to touch that worry and that concern that we may have, Father God, with the help of the defense, the bodies of our loved ones, Lord God. I'm asking, Father God, that you remove that heaviness off our hearts, Lord God, that you will lift us up, Father God. I'm asking right now, Father God, for the worry and concern that we may have, Father God, in our hearts and our minds about our children, Lord God, that you lift their heaviness up, Lord God. I'm asking, Father God, that problem, that concern that we have with that bill, Lord God, that transportation or that house situation, Lord God. I'm asking that you would step in, Lord God, and move that out of the way as well, Lord God. I'm asking right now, Father God, that you would unpack all these things out of our hearts, Lord God, that we'll get every heavy weight, every heavy burden that we may carry at your feet, Lord God, because, Lord God, you are our burden, Lord God. You said we are to cast our cares upon you, Lord God, because you care for us, Lord God. And we know, Father God, you will make a way out of no way, Lord God. So I'm asking right now, Father God, you will do what you do best, Lord God. That's simply see about your people, Lord God. I'm asking on today, Father God, you will open up our minds to you, Lord God. You will regulate our minds, Lord God, and alter our thoughts, Lord God, so we can loose that word to you, Lord God. I'm asking right now, Father God, you will sever all these things that are not of you, Lord God, that hold us captive in our minds, Lord God. They have us that cause us to have an altered perspective, Lord God, even a way of altered way of feeling about a thing, Lord God. I'm asking today, Father God, that you will make that change on inside of us, Lord God, that only you know how to make, Lord God. I'm asking, Father God, you will touch the hearts, Lord God, and loose the shackles and the chains and the the things that cause bondages, Father God, in our hearts, Lord God, that make us feel a type of way, Lord God. God, I'm asking that you release all the word, Lord God, and that we'll lay it at your feet, Father God. All the concerns, Lord God, at your feet on tonight, Father God. All the problems, Lord God, the challenges that we may face, Lord God. Everything, Lord God, whatever it is, Lord God, we just want to give it all to you, Lord, like, on tonight, Father God. We outpour ourselves, Lord God, totally and completely, Lord God. We're asking, Father God, to touch our hearts, Lord God, and release those grudges, Lord God, and we'll have a heart of forgiveness, Lord God. We're asking us today, Father God, release, Father God, that pain that we feel, Father God, from that past relationship, Father God, the brokenness on our hearts, Lord God, and we release that to you as well, Lord God, that you will be our heart mender on today, Father God, that situation, that circumstance, Lord God, that happened with our loved one, Father God. And they said a thing to us, Lord God, that caused to make us feel some type of way, Lord God. We release that thing to you as well, Lord God. Whatever it is, Lord God, that caused to have such a heaviness within our hearts, Lord God, we just outpour it to you on tonight, Father God. And we give it to you, Lord God, because we know that you can handle that thing, Father God. We know that you can make it right, Lord God. We know that you are our avenger, Lord God. So whatever it is, Lord God, that someone did to us, Lord God, and we feel like we want to get them back, Lord God, we give it to you, Lord God, because we know, Father God, if you stand before us, that no one can be against us, Lord God. Oh God, I'm asking that you touch each and every
every situation within their lives, the people are tonight, Father God. I'm asking, Father God, you touch each and every person in the sanctuary, Lord God, and even that hidden thing, Father God, that your people have not even spoken of, Lord God. If it causes heaviness on their hearts, Lord God, if it's a weight on their shoulders, Lord God, if it's a strain on their brain, Lord God, I'm asking that you will release it on tonight, Father God. I'm asking, Father God, that you will succumb your people in your peace on tonight, Father God, that you will endow them, Lord God. I'm asking, Father God, that you will fill them up, Father God, with your unconditional love on tonight, Father God, and wrap your arms around them today, Father God. I'm asking, Father God, you remove any concerns, Father God, of worrying about what people say about them, Lord God, and that we will not have that worry either, Lord God. That we'll walk out the door with our heads held high, Father God, and our crown for justice and righteousness, Lord God, knowing that we are who you say we are because of who you are in us, Lord God. Oh, Father God, we thank you for who you are in us, Lord God. We thank you, Father God, for molding us and shaping us into who you are becoming, Lord God. And I ask that we continue to embrace, Lord God, that you continue, Father God, to keep us in that place of perfect peace, Lord God. No matter what we may be going through, Father God, no matter what situation or circumstance we may be, Lord God, we know, Father God, you are right there, Lord God. Oh God, we just want to say thank you on tonight, Father God, for loosing us from these things on tonight, Father God. Oh God, we come before you right now, Father God, we invite you in, Father God, to these things, Lord God, because we know, Father God, that you hold all power in your hand, Father God. That whatever it is, Lord God, that you can make a way for that thing, Lord God, that you can sit on that thing, that you can stop the thing and try to start, Lord God, and that you will open that door, Father God, for that thing that we thought was locked, Father God. That you will go before us, Lord God, and you will unloose that thing, Father God. We thought that was tied up, Father God, that was locked up behind the door that we had no access to, Father God. You are the one, Father God, who grants us the access, Lord God. So we thank you on tonight, Father God, for bringing us the access, Lord God. We thank you, Father God, for opening up the doors to those resources, Lord God. We thank you, Father God, for each and every opportunity that you are presenting for us, Lord. Oh, Father God, we thank you, Father God. We thank you, Father God, for unloosing, Father God, and lifting up every heavy weight, every heavy burden that we may be carrying on tonight, Father God. Whether it may be for ourselves or someone else, Lord God, we thank you, Lord God. Because we know, Father God, that many times, Lord God, we are concerned for other people, Lord God. We worry about other people, Lord God. We want the best for them in their life, Lord God. But we're going to give you those things, Lord God, because we know, Father God, that you hold our power in your hand, Lord God. And you are the only one, Father God, who can save those who need to be saved, Father God. You are the only one, Father God, who can heal those who need to be healed, Father God. You are the only one, Father God, who can provide for those who need to provide, Father God. So we're asking us tonight, Father God, you will be the provider, Father God. You'll be the healer and the protector, Father God. And that you will be the savior on tonight, Father God, for those who need to be saved, Lord. Oh, Lord, we thank you, Father God. We lift you up, Father God. We glorify you and we magnify you on tonight, Father God. We bless you, Father God. You are the King of Kings. You are the Lord of Lords. You are the great I am, the Heavenly Father. You're worthy to be praised, God. And we want to give you everything, Lord God, that's required of us, that's due unto you, Lord God. Because you deserve it, Father God. You are more than worthy of all the praise and glory on tonight, Father God. Oh, Lord, we thank you, Father God. We bless you, glorify. We bless you, Father God. We glorify, Lord God. And we praise your holy name on tonight, Father God. Lord, we thank you, we thank you, we thank you, Father God. We thank you, Lord God, for everything that you are to us and for us, Lord God, and everything that you will be for us, Father God, in the future, Lord God, because we know, Father God, that you are, because you said that you are, Father God. We thank you for being the great I am within our lives, Lord. We thank you, we thank you, we thank you, Lord God, that we can succeed, Father God, that we are successful because of you, Lord God. We thank you this morning, Father God, that even in our failure, Lord God, you show us, Father God, the winning thing in that, Lord God, the lessons that we have to learn, Lord. Oh, Father God, we thank you, Lord. We thank you for promoting and shaping us, Lord God. We thank you, Father God, for our divine destiny, Lord God, and our purpose in you, Lord God. And I'm asking us today, Father God, we continue, Father God, to embrace all those things that are of you, Lord God. And we continue, Father God, to loose and let go of those things that are not of you, Lord God. Lord, we just lift you up on tonight, Father God. We thank you, Lord God, for being in our midst and being in our presence on tonight, Lord God. We thank you, Father God, for interceding on our behalf, Lord God, as we intercede for others, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, for being who you are to us, Lord God, for loving us the way that you do, Father God, for your grace and your mercy. Just, Lord God, just overall for who you are for us within our lives, Lord. We thank you, we thank you, we thank you, we thank you, we thank you tonight, Lord God. Lord, I'm asking right now, you continue, Father God, to hear each and every prayer we pray, Father God. Inside of our hearts, Lord God, even in our life, Lord God, that you will touch each and every prayer, Father God, on our little sheep tonight, Father God, that you will consider them and answer them, Lord. In your Son, Jesus' name, I pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
And remember, she said, you are everything that God said that you are. You are everything that God said that you are. So stop degrading yourself. We're going to get ready to get our offering, and then I'm going to get ready to dismiss you guys so that you guys can go. I love you guys so much. I love you guys so, so much. I appreciate the pressing. It's a blessing in the pressing, y'all.